Okay, here we are. This is Mr. Masley here with a special IB physics video lecture in Minecraft. In this lecture, I'm specifically going to be using Minecraft to explain diffraction and Huygens principle. And while this is definitely 100% just a gimmick, Huygens principle and diffraction actually works very well in Minecraft because the Minecraft water actually obeys Huygens principle perfectly. And it makes a pretty good demo of what I'm trying to explain when I talk about Huygens principle. So just as a quick reminder, Huygens principle is the idea that every point of an advancing wavefront is a new center of disturbance from which emanate independent waves in all directions. So what this means is if you have a wave moving from left to right, as is the case in the wavefront displayed here, each individual point on any line in that wavefront is behaving like a center of disturbance with waves emanating out from that center of disturbance in all directions. So what this means is I can pick any one point on that wavefront, and it will behave like a single center of disturbance with a kind of circular wave emanating out in all directions. And the reason why this works is that if I line up all the points like this, you can see that the area of overlap that all the waves share is right here. So this is where the next line of the wavefront occurs, and you can see that that's true. But this can be a little abstract, and Minecraft can actually help us with this because the Minecraft water actually obeys Huygens principle. What I mean when I say that the Minecraft water obeys Huygens principle is that any one individual block of water acts as a center of disturbance where water is emanating from it in all directions like this. So this is obviously not actually a wave. This is just water emanating out until it kind of dissipates into nothing. So it's not exactly the same, but it's close enough that similar properties are observed. So any one water tile emanates water outward in all directions like this. Because water tiles emanate water outward like that in all directions, if you line up multiple water tiles, you'll notice that the parts that I lined up are kind of adding together. They're constructively interfering with each other. So instead of one single dot emanating out in all directions, when they're interfering with each other, they create this pattern where all the water is kind of moving in one direction in that way. And if I continue to line them up, each individual point of water is acting as a center of disturbance, but because they're all lined up like this, just like centers of disturbances are in a wavefront, all the water kind of moves in one direction that way. So this is behaving like a single wave moving in one very specific direction, rather than a bunch of individual points all radiating outward in all directions. But in truth, they're basically the same thing because the individual points are interfering with each other to create this total pattern. So that's what Huygens' principle is saying. It's saying that this one total wave moving in this one direction can actually be modeled as a bunch of individual centers of disturbance where the water is radiating outward in every direction. And because of the interference, it behaves like one big wave, even though these are all actually centers of disturbance. One thing that I'm extra excited about with the Minecraft water is that because it obeys Huygens' principle, the diffraction patterns that occur when it encounters a barrier are actually the same that occur when waves encounter a barrier. So for example, we've got all this water lined up here and it's encountering a barrier right here. It can't get through. So the idea is that this water is kind of behaving as one large wave moving forward and impacting a barrier here. And so if I make a small opening in the barrier, diffraction is going to occur, and it would occur in the way that we would expect it to for a single slit. So I open it up for a single slit. And you can see that it's occurring basically as we would predict it. So for a single slit, we have this full wave impacting the boundary, and after it spreads out in all directions, leaving the boundary. So this is what we mean when we talk about diffraction, the single wave spreading outwards in all directions after it exits a small opening in a barrier. We can also observe the pattern for a multi-slit experiment. So I'm going to open up a few more. And I can see that because of the interference pattern, there are certain places where these waves are constructively interfering with each other to create a slightly different pattern than we've seen before. So this is the image for a multi-slit experiment. And again, this obviously is a little bit different as well, because with an actual wave, there would be points of destructive interference as well, and the Minecraft water can't model that. But it still gives you an idea of what Huygens' principle is saying, because each of these individual points of water is behaving as a center of disturbance where water radiates outward in all directions. That's why we see the pattern that we do when waves encounter a boundary. Finally, we can just completely remove the boundary. And if we completely remove it, we can see that we now have a single overall wave where each individual point is behaving as a center of disturbance. So that's a way that you can use the Minecraft water to understand Huygens' principle.